Well, I envy you.
What? That's ridiculous.
No, it's not. You have a choice. I didn't. None of us did, but you do, and you're choosing wrong. I don't care how miserable your human life is.
My life is not miserable. It's not perfect. And nobody's life is perfect.
Mine was. Absolutely perfect. There were things I still wanted. To be married with a nice house and a husband to kiss me when he came home. A family of my own. Royce King was the most eligible bachelor in town. I barely knew him. But I was young. I was in love with the idea of love. On the last night of my life, I left a friend's house late. I wasn't far from home.
Hey, Rose! Come over here.
Here, hold this.
Hey, come over here. We've been waiting for you. There she is.
Royce. You're drunk.
Isn't she lovely, John? I told you she was a looker.
Well, it's hard to say with all those clothes on.
What do you say, Rose? Why don't we take off a few layers?
Stop. I'll see you tomorrow, sober.
Hey, where do you think you're going?
Stop.
Come back.
Hey,
you'll do as I say.
They left me in the street thinking I was dead. Believe me, I wanted to be. Carlisle found me. He smelled all the blood. Thought he was helping me.
I'm sorry.
I got my revenge on them. One at a time. Saved Royce for last so he'd know I was coming. I was a little theatrical back then. Things got better after I found Emmett. But we'll always be this. Frozen. Never moving forward. That's what I miss the most. Possibilities. Sitting on a front porch somewhere. Emmett gray-haired by my side. Surrounded by our grandchildren. Their laughter.
I understand that that's what you want. There's nothing I'm ever gonna want more than Edward.
You're wrong again. After you've been changed, there's one thing you'll want more. One thing you'll kill for. Blood.